Welcome back to the Weekly Story. My name is Tom, and I know you know the drill by now. So on this week's episode, what I'm going to discuss is a question that's come up a lot recently, and it's, can you still cash flow on a condo investment by putting 20% down? So that means at the end of the month, you got your mortgage, your condo fees, and your taxes, and then you have your overall what you can rent it for. Are you going to be walking away with a few bucks in your pocket, or are you going to be negative? And the example we're going to go over today is based on putting 20% down, and I will show you all the numbers in a second. Okay, so we are going to get into the numbers, but before that, I'm going to put on my smart person glasses so that you know I know what I'm talking about. So in the example we're going to use, the purchase price of the condo is $500,000. And in this example, we're putting 20% down, so that's a $100,000 down payment on a $500,000 purchase price. That means that our mortgage, and the mortgage terms we're gonna use is a 5-year fixed mortgage at 3.09% with a 25-year amortization, and that's very conservative. You can probably get a lower mortgage than that. Which means that at that $500,000 purchase price with 20% down, your monthly mortgage payment is $1,911.50. And then in this example, we're gonna use condo fees as $380 per month. And your overall monthly taxes are gonna be $166, which over a yearly period is about $2,000 per year. So if we add that all up, we have the mortgage at $1,911.50, plus the condo fees of 380, plus the taxes of 166, it gives us a total overall carrying cost of 2457. Now in this example, the condo that we've purchased, its average rental rate is about $2,200. So on paper, it looks like we are $250 negative a month. But I wanna show you, as someone that myself has invested in real estate, and I have a lot of clients that are savvy investors, another way you can look at these numbers, where even if you're negative on paper, you're actually still building a ton of equity, and I'd rather have my condo go up 5 to 7% a year in appreciation than make an extra $100 a month. So stick with me and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so as we jump into the next example, what I wanna go over is actually in that first year of the mortgage, you're paying about $22,930. But the way that mortgages work is in that first year, you're paying about 53% of your payment is going to interest, and 47% is going to the principal payment. So your interest payment average on that first year is about $1,009 per month, plus the $380 of condo fees, plus the $166 of taxes, and that gives us $1,555 a month. So the way I look at it is that's money that you're never going to get back. It's interest, it's condo fees, and it's taxes. Now, if you do the calculations on that, the $2,200 will absolutely cover. But what a lot of people don't realize is that as long as your investment covers the interest, the condo fees, and the taxes, essentially anything that you're paying that you're not going to get back, you're still kind of cash flowing every month. It's just in a completely different way. So when I talked about before, when we were negative $257 a month, because the interest, the condo fees, and the taxes are all being covered, we're not actually negative. All it is a forced savings plan, because that's your principal. So the mortgage calculations that we're using was your interest payment on average was just over about $1,000. But the principal payment every month, and that's money in your pocket, that's a forced savings plan, was about $900. So even if we were negative $300, $400, $500 a month, as long as that negative is going towards the principal portion of the mortgage, it's really just a forced savings plan. So hopefully I explained that okay to everybody. I know it's a little bit tricky, but it's a savvy way to look at the numbers, and don't get caught up in the, is it gonna cash flow? Because long term, it doesn't actually matter. If it goes up in appreciation every year, I'd take that over cash flow every single day. Anyways, I hope that was helpful. If you have any questions, let me know. And the last thing I'll say is, the longer your mortgage goes and the more you pay off, the more over time your percentage of payment becomes more focused to the principal. So keep paying, keep paying, keep renting it out. Rents will go up. This is how people build long-term wealth. Thank you so much for watching. We'll talk soon.